everybody, welcome to Frannie's Hair. Today we're going to take a look at some of the iced colors in the Raquel Welch line. I figured we'd do a color focus because I know that is one of the most difficult things to get right when you are shopping online. So stay tuned. Okay, so one of the most asked questions, if not the most asked question I get is about color. How do I know which color is going to work with my complexion or which color will look good on me? And that's a really difficult question to answer. And I do find that the more that you wear different wigs in different colors, the more you can see yourself in different colors. But at first, that first wig is really tough because you want to feel like you look good in it and you are used to looking a certain way in whatever color you've been wearing your hair. So a lot of people are trying to match that, at least for their first wig. But that challenge is not just for new wig wearers. I know that when I'm looking at a color, I go online and I search reviews and I look at all different reviewers wearing the same color and the same wig if I possibly can. Because even if you get the same color in the same manufacturer but in a different wig, you can have some variance in the color. And sometimes you can even have that variance in the same style. So that makes it more difficult as well. In my private Facebook group, a lot of people post pictures of their wigs and the colors that they're wearing, or they'll do some comparisons of wigs and colors, and it's a really great reference. So if you're not over there yet, come join us over at Frannie's Hair. I am learning so much. You can learn so much, I'm sure. There's so much to learn there and to share, and we do support one another. And also, we have V, our resident stylist, who is excellent with color. So if you're having a difficult time with color, you can schedule a free one-on-one video consultation where she can see your complexion and help you choose the right color. In the meantime, I'm going to try to do some color focuses. And today, I'm calling this one Ice Ice Baby, because I'm going to be looking at some of the iced colors in the Raquel Welch line. So let's start with this one. This one is Shaded Iced Latte Macchiato. And I'm going to read to you the description. It says, a contrast of sandy blonde and cool platinum highlights with medium brown rooting. So you can see the medium brown rooting here. And this is Boudoir Glam. It's a high fashion style. I'll turn for you too so you can see it. But this is not a review of the wig. I did do a review of this wig, and I will link in the description below any of the wigs that I've done full reviews on. I'll put those links underneath. If I haven't done a review of one of these, I will be doing it, so stay tuned for that. But this is really all about the color today. Okay, so here you can see the medium brown rooting. And it's in a contract of sandy blonde. I don't know if you can see the sandy blonde in there. And cool platinum highlights. And this definitely is on the cooler side. You can see the cool platinum highlights. Okay, and let me just spin for you so you can see how the color's applied all over this wig. It's a really pretty color, and it is on the cooler side with still a little bit of warmth. Now I have another wig in this color, and this is Voltage. So this is the interesting thing. It's also Shaded Iced Latte Macchiato, but it looks cooler, right? There is a little warmth to it. I don't know if you can see that, but yet I find it to be cooler and lighter than this one, and they're the same color. Very interesting. Actually, I think I'm going to put it on for you just so you can see the difference, how the wig looks against my complexion. So you got this look, now I'm going to put on this one. Okay, so here you go. This is Voltage in the same color. Now I'm going to hold up the Boudoir Glam so you can see, and I'm going to spin in Voltage. You still have the dark roots here. I do think it's cooler and lighter. A little bit.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, moving on to the next color. Okay, this is Influence Elite. For all you bang girls, you can wear bangs with this. Let me just hold them down there. This is in Shaded Iced Cappuccino, and that's described as a natural light brown with ash blonde highlights and medium brown rooting. So if you're looking for something in the brunette family that is ashier or cooler, this could be a great color for you. And that's what I think of when I think of the iced colors. I think of something cooler, ice, obviously. And these are all in different families. So I wouldn't say that this is a brunette necessarily. I don't know how I would classify this. Maybe along the blonde with the some brown in it. But this I would consider to be a brunette, but with cool highlights in it. Okay, I'm just going to spin for you and show you the color all the way around. It's really hard to get a brunette in a cooler tone. Usually they come with a golden highlight. I don't know why. But this is one that you do get that ashier highlight, so that's nice. Okay, on to the next color. And while these are all iced, they really are in different color families. So the iced, shaded iced latte macchiato, I would say is more along the lines of an ashy blonde with some brown, whereas this is more along the lines of a brunette with some ashy blonde. So, and then you'll see the next one I'm going to show you is going to be in the gray family, another iced color. And you think of grays as iced anyway. There are a few grays that are mixed with reds in some of the lines that'll warm it up a little bit, or mixed with some golden highlights. But this next one is Upstage in Iced Granita. And you can see here, this is definitely a cool gray. I'm going to put that on for you next. So pretty. Okay, this is Upstage in Iced Granita. And Iced Granita is definitely in the gray family, as you can see. And it's described as a blend of gray with off-white and platinum blonde and a touch of light golden brown. So, I guess, I don't know if you can see this. Do you see any light golden brown? To me, it looks like it gets to a darker gray at the bottom. And I'm going to spin for you because I don't know if you can see these here. That does not look like a, what did that say, golden brown to me at all. Maybe up here, do you see some? Maybe in here a little bit. Can kind of see that. But definitely a cool color. I'll spin and show you all the color. It's a really pretty wig too. I haven't reviewed this one yet. I'm going to have to. To me, this is a gray when you still want to have that youthful look, especially the style too. Really pretty. Okay, so if we're going to look at this, this is definitely the gray family. Again, even the cooler of the shaded iced latte macchiato, not nearly as cool as this, and still more in the blonde family. And then, of course, this is the brunette family, and this would show up a lot warmer, even though compared to other brunettes, this is definitely ashier. Okay, now I'm going to move on to, I have a wig in iced sweet cream and shaded iced sweet cream, so you'll get to see the difference in that. But this, I'm just going to hold this up while I'm wearing this, is clearly warmer. Clearly has golden to it as compared to what I'm wearing here. And let's just compare to the shaded iced latte macchiato. Much lighter and more golden. All right, I'm going to put this on next. Okay, this is Bella Vita in iced sweet cream. And I think if you see me not next to another wig, this looks pretty white, pretty cool. But I'm gonna show you that next to, let's just take what we just had on, the iced granita, this is definitely warmer and more blonde. than say this gray, silvery white. So iced granita is a pale blonde with a hint of platinum highlighting. So it really is blonde. And these are the colors that are so difficult to pick up on camera even, but definitely from a swatch on a website. So I think it's so important to, when you're looking at a specific color, watch as many reviews as you can and look at it outside and inside. I know I haven't gone outside today. It's already dark out, so I can't. But I am planning on taking these outside and doing a photo comparison, and I'll put that up in the Facebook group. So if you're over there, you'll get to see each of these wigs side by side outdoors. All right, but this is definitely more blonde, I would say. You can really see the, I almost want to say yellow, golden color in there. All right, next I'm going to compare this to the shaded ice sweet cream. So it's the same color, pale blonde with a hint of platinum highlighting plus dark roots. But when it's shaded and it has the dark roots, the darkness comes through further down in the wig, and it does have a different tone to it, as you can see here. And I'm going to put this on for you. Okay, so this is current events in shaded ice sweet cream, as opposed to just the ice sweet cream that does not have the shading. And you can see how a little bit of shading can make all the difference depending on your complexion. I have darker eyebrows, I have a warmer complexion, and I think that the shading definitely helps me to wear an ashier tone. So if you are a warmer person but you want to wear an ashier tone, I would say look for something with some rooting that just gives it a little bit of warmth, but you still get that cool color that you're looking for. And I think this is the perfect example of that. I'm going to spin around and show you this color, and you can see how the shading goes through the wig a little bit, and it just changes it slightly. Such a difference, huh? Okay, so let me just compare this to the shaded iced latte macchiato so you can get a comparison if you were looking at these colors. So this is definitely cooler and lighter. They both have the shading. And this does give me the Beltress British Milk Tea vibe, this color there. So if you like that color, this could be a good one for you. Okay, so I hope you found this helpful, and I'm going to be doing more color focuses because, like I said, that is the most asked question I get. It's always about color. So if you have some color focuses that you'd like to see, put them in the comments below and I will try to get to as many as I can. Also, come to our private Facebook group, Frannie's Hair. Schedule an appointment with V. She can help you with color. She's great at that. She's an artist also. And of course, you can contact me over there. And if you're interested in any of these wigs here, I'll have links to them in the description below so you can go check the wigs out as well. As always, thank you so much for joining me. I truly appreciate it. Remember to make it your own, and I'll see you soon.